And over the course of my life, I've been aware of the various ways we can enter this week. And I've been in churches where almost no one comes after today. They come back on Easter Sunday. And I've been in churches also where the place is full, but everyone's in their own private world, having their own relationship with God. And all of that is legitimate, and all of that is a part of where we are in our journey. But there's another way that we'd like to invite you into this week. We purposefully did not use the full Passion reading this morning. The most important part theologically and spiritually about Palm Sunday is what we did at the door this morning. The blessing of the palms and the walking with Jesus as Jesus enters Jerusalem. That is the whole point of Palm Sunday. And the point of Palm Sunday is a choice that you and I make. It's a choice that defines our whole life, not just the life that we live from now to Easter Sunday. And the choice is, how are we going to accompany our Lord? How are we going to accompany our Lord in his journey? Where do we find ourselves in that journey? Where are we willing to show up? Where haven't we been? Where are we afraid to go? Where do we not want to go? Certainly not alone. Where do we need a friend, a spouse, a family, and a whole congregation? And so I invite us in this week for us to gather as a community. We can't really celebrate the fullness of Holy Week unless we come together as a community. My celebration of Holy Week will be incomplete without each of you and the many congregations throughout the world. You and I cannot make this journey alone. And it's not just a holy journey. Every part of this journey this week is a journey that you and I make in our lives. We know about triumphal entries in our life. And Maundy Thursday, as we continue this Holy Week, more than any other congregation I know, this is a Eucharistic-centered congregation. Everything we do begins with what happens at this table on Sunday morning. I know because I see it in your eyes when you come to receive communion and the various ways that you express your love for God and the preciousness of the Holy Eucharist. And Maundy Thursday is the celebration of the institution of the Holy Eucharist. We think about it sometimes as about the foot washing. And the foot washing plays a critical role on Maundy Thursday. Just as every Sunday we gather at this table to receive the Holy Eucharist, again, that's not for us alone. That's not just the affirmation of our spiritual life and journey with God, and everyone else is at the side. When we receive the Holy Eucharist, we are called, we are compelled to be sent. The powerful words at the end of our Sunday morning worship, when we are sent out to live and breathe and serve the gospel. And so we begin that on Maundy Thursday, when we wash each other's feet. The symbolism of Maundy Thursday's washing of the feet for is aligned to Sunday morning. And then the stripping of the altar, stripping of ourselves, of all that we love. We love the Eucharist, we love ministry, we love the healing in the Gospels. And we just had a glimpse of it in one day Thursday, and then it's all stripped away. And then we enter Good Friday. We all have our Good Fridays. So one day of the week, of Holy Week, that we seem to get the most, a Good Friday. And we feel the power of Jesus on the cross, dying with us, suffering with us, asking questions with us. And then we enter Holy Saturday, a time of deep waiting. Waiting with the apostles, waiting with the disciples, waiting with Mary, not having any idea that the story was going to end the way it did. Waiting. Waiting, not even knowing what the next part of the narrative would be like. And so, I invite you into the fullness of that experience. We can't do it justice by going home and reading these readings. We have to do it together. What makes this human experience so powerful and transformative is when we don't make the journey alone. And what will make Holy Week most powerful and transformative is if we don't do it. So I invite you.
For me, Holy Week is an invitation into profound honesty and profound authenticity. It's one of the weeks of the liturgical year that we, together as a congregation, move from the triumph of the entry into Jerusalem to the horror of Jesus' execution, and just the heartrending grief of crucifixion, and the waiting for what comes next on Holy Saturday. It's an invitation into really paying close attention to where our life story intersects this part of the story of the life of Christ. We can always locate ourselves somewhere in this story. You mentioned earlier, you wrote about in the Voices, that choosing life is about choosing to stay with Jesus. Are we willing to choose life? Are we willing to really stay close to Jesus through every event in our lives? It's easy to do the joyful ones. I mean, I'm good with staying with the donkey and taking care of the donkey. And you all can, like, do the rest of this week. It's more comfortable. But if I really want to stay with Jesus, I have to choose to move with him, to stay present with Jesus means to stay present to everything that's going on in my life and the life of those around me. I notice sometimes a way that I separate from Jesus is through my desire for things to be other than how they are. I'm thinking of a friend in my life who's really suffering, and I want to make it better for her. And there is no making it better for her. And I want to say things, the easy things, like, it's going to be okay. And it is going to be okay in a big metaphysical way, but it may not be okay, you know, right now. And so a part of staying with Jesus is me refraining from saying those easy things that aren't really comforting because they're not real. Staying with Jesus is just staying present and being the presence of God to each other, not trying to offer easy answers because there aren't any.
A priest, spiritual director, who I woke up thinking about this morning, used to say that the most important, powerful part of our lives is choosing to show up. Because I see this in spiritual direction a lot with people. People negate their spirituality, they negate how close they are to God. And it's this showing up, just showing up. It's not about what we do to get closer to God, it's us showing up so that God can come closer to us, so that God can enter our lives through the Eucharist, through ministry, Good Friday, when we venerate the cross. We'll have the Stations of the Cross this week. We will enter Holy Saturday in silence and in awe. All we have to do is show up. Really, throughout our whole life, all we have to do is show up. Show up, as the Roman Catholics say, with intention and desire. Intention and desire. And God does the rest. And you know that in your lives. I know that in my life. When I have the least capacity to show effort, that God is there for me. God shows up when I show up.
There's something about the drama of our liturgical tradition that trains us to be able to show up, you know, to physically gather with you all outside and slap the wrists of those who are trying to get the palms. And it created a lot of joy for me. And as we processed it, I felt the joy that the disciples must have felt with Jesus. And we're kind of this ragtag group, just like they were. You know, it didn't look like a royal procession, right? He's riding in on the donkey. But it was joyful. And it was triumphant in its way, and I wouldn't be able to experience that if I couldn't experience it with you. You create that for me. I can enter into that experience of Jesus' life and my own because of you. And that's true through all of Holy Week, that the drama of the liturgy helps us to show up. I have a poem.
Just happened from
home. Very convenient with here. This is a poem by Joanna Herder, who I honestly don't know much about other than that she's a Mennonite pastor in Kansas, and she writes a blog called Spacious Faith. It came to me by way of the Holy Facebook page. God of the cross, tottering down the streets of Jerusalem on a donkey, you are not the Savior we expect. Your power doesn't look like the power we want our God to have. Your wisdom makes no sense to us. We're happy to join the crowd waving branches, but not so sure we want to follow you through this Holy Week, into the temple courts, into the upper room, into the Garden of Gethsemane, to the high priest's house, to the assembly of elders, to Pilate, to Herod, to the place of the skull, to the foot of the cross. We need you to go with us on this journey. Grant us clear vision, courageous hearts, persistent steps. Even though we know what this week will bring, we sing Hosanna, Hosanna. Save us, we beseech you. Amen.
God bless you.